going to build a fully functional skateboard using only popsicle sticks. So I was definitely cutting through some uncharted territory. I honestly had no idea how I was going to build a board strong enough to support my weight.
And it's not like there's a YouTube tutorial on how to do it either.
So I started doing a little bit of research and I found some pretty good information. Skateboards and longboards usually consist of 7 to 10 layers of wood. The more layers there are, the stronger and stiffer the board will be.
So I'm going to make mine 10 ply, maybe 11.
So to get started, I traced the outline of another one of my boards on a piece of cardboard. That way I could just cut it out and have a guide to follow. So there I was with my 1500 popsicle sticks and wood glue, ready to start building. But then I realized,
I don't have a pattern.
I needed to come up with a pattern that I could repeat for each layer, holding the board together lengthwise and widthwise. So I played around with the sticks for about an hour, stacking and arranging them in different ways, till I started just gluing stuff together, trying not to leave any gaps so I don't compromise the integrity of the board. Then I had a great idea. I was gonna make a giant plank of wood and then just cut it out to the shape of the board when I'm done.
All along the bottom here, they're going totally straight like that because that's where I'm gonna put the grip tape. And then here, I'm gonna do several layers of ones going across along with the ones going straight to hold it all together. So I just need 9 more layers.
As I started to lay out my second layer, I quickly realized that this was going to take me a long time. It took 20-30 minutes for the glue to dry alone, and then I needed to apply pressure to it while it dries to keep it in place. So to make the glue dry faster, I tried the heat method. By applying heat with a hairdryer, it sped up the drying process, along with adding airflow, which also speeds things up.
Hey, this is working.
It was really hard to keep things neat, and with every single layer I made, they ended up just getting sloppier and sloppier. Some of the sticks did not want to stay down, but I had no choice but to just keep going and see how it would play out. Plus, once I broke out the glue gun, things started to go a lot smoother. So stick by stick, I was finally making some progress.
All right, I'm officially up to 8 layers, and it's getting pretty strong, but the inside of this board right now is super soupy with all the glue. I'm gonna have to let it dry overnight, so I'm gonna come back tomorrow and we'll finish this thing up. And if I get this thing to work, I'm taking it to the skate park. This ends today.
Hey, not bad.
I think it needs 1 or 2 more layers and then we're done.
The last 2 layers went by really fast and then I let it dry for a few hours.
We are officially done. I have 10 layers of popsicle sticks in this board right now. And now it's time for the part I'm really nervous about, the stress test.
I laid the board across 2 dumbbells approximately where the wheels would be.
Ooh, this makes me super nervous.
And to my surprise, it held my weight.
I can feel it giving a little bit. I'm gonna try 1 foot, here we go. Whoa, this thing holds.
Next on the to-do list was to trace the cardboard cutout that I made and drill the holes for the trucks. Then there was nothing left to do but cut the board out to the right shape, which turned out to be the most difficult part.
Because I cannot find the power saw for the life of me.
That's right, I had to cut this board out by hand. I started with a knife, cutting off any sticks that were poking out from the board.
Now this is just a solid piece of wood right here. I'm impressed.
Then I started to go to town on that board with a handsaw. And since I couldn't cut those curved lines, I had to cut just one little corner at a time. After 45 minutes, my hand was about to fall off.
This was supposed to be like a fun, laid-back, easy project for me. Considering I just did a triathlon in concrete shoes, I wanted to do something that wasn't so physically exhausting, but here I am.
I was sweating like crazy, but I was getting there.
I never in a million years thought I would get this far with this little saw. This saw isn't even made for wood. This one is, but the teeth are too coarse. It just keeps breaking the popsicle sticks.
I was on the home stretch, and then finally...
Yes! Woo! Yes! Look at this thing! This thing's freaking sick!
So the next day, I started putting the grip tape and trucks on it. I was so excited to try this thing out.
Man, this really takes me back. I've always loved skateboarding, and like most kids my age, I grew up with like the Tony Hawk game. When I was a kid, I used to skateboard until it was so dark I couldn't even see. My brother and I even built our own quarter pipe that we used to drag out to the road. The trucks are on, the grip tape's on, this thing's looking sick, it's feeling sturdy, but it just started raining.
Finally, I had a nice day and I was able to ride it, and this thing was working wonderfully. It held my weight and it was feeling pretty good, but it was time to put this thing to the real test.
All right, we at the skate park now. I'm gonna try to get one of these skaters to do it because I'm honestly pretty scared.
Down to ride this thing?
Knowing that it's totally made out of popsicle sticks,
yeah.
If you get hurt, you can't sue me.
So there were a few tests that I wanted to put this board through. The obvious one is just holding weight and being rideable, but I wanted to see if this could handle a kickflip and a drop-in off the vert ramp.
It's definitely holding better than I thought it would. I'm pretty impressed.
Yo!
Do a kickflip.
This board was very hard to get off the ground because it didn't have a proper tail on it, but after many failed attempts, this kid was still determined to land a clean kickflip.
Yo! Oh yeah, we're gonna try to ride it still.
The board snapped right in the middle after landing the kickflip, but it was surprisingly still rideable.
It's like an inchworm. That was rough.
There was one last challenge this board had to complete, dropping in off the quarter pipe. I tried it a couple times on some smaller ramps because I haven't done this in over a decade, but this one guy was super curious and he was up to the challenge.
Yo!
This guy had everyone in the park sweating. Not only was he about to drop in on a skateboard made of popsicle sticks, but a broken skateboard made of popsicle sticks. He said his goodbyes.
I'm sorry, Mom.
And he jumped. Yo!
That was freaking awesome, bro.
I think I did a good job building this thing. It did everything I wanted it to. That's all I got.